So, welcome to the Orion Show. We've got a bit of a special guest representing Soul Mavericks from London. It's midair! I'm Brad.
Chilling.
Because I must have done a really sick workshop. I was watching it from the sidelines and I was like, yeah, man knows his stuff. And I was thinking, okay, yeah, like, if I knew that when I started breaking up, it would be really useful. So those kids are no excuse now. How's your experience been overall when you start up with what it's like now? Like, do you look back and you're like, yeah, you know, I've made it kind of thing.
Because I'm still thinking about it. I wouldn't look at it as I've made it. I would look at it as I've come a long way. Like, I definitely can say, sometimes I look back and I think, oh my God, I've done quite a lot of breaking.
Yeah.
To be honest, it's the most I've given in anything I've ever done. Like, most things I've kind of just, as Kevin said, I've flipped. You know, but this is what I've given my most to. Because it's so, it's goals that I want to, that I aspire to, and I want to achieve still. That's a deep question.
Like interrogation.
I don't know, I'm just trying to be, the best thing I can say is I can't be specific right now and say this is it, but the best thing I want to say is that I want to be the best that I can personally. As Kev, not try to be a flitter. Yeah.
Is that even a word, Kev? Kev, is that a word?
Flitter, he says we are.
Flitter? Flitter. Yeah. Is there a battle, a particular battle that you thought, okay, I actually want to win that, or I actually want to get to a particular level in that battle?
You know what, it's actually changed for me. Before it was like, I had this weird, I think where I wanted to win the Red Bull BC one, UK champ, solo champion or something.
Yeah.
I got to a point in my ranking where I realised that, okay, it's not always about winning things, you know? Like, it's great to win, like, it's amazing. There's roles you've got as a b-boy, and there's b-boys that we don't know about that have roles within a crew that help the crew get to the next level.
Yeah.
Not everyone can be a Messi, not everyone can be, you know, a Ronaldo. There's other people, there's defenders and midfielders, you know? And for me, I just want to be strong in my position, what I can bring to my crew and take my crew to the next level. And that's what changed my perspective of breaking a lot, you know? Like, I don't think of it as I need to be the top guy anymore. It's like, I need to be the best for Soul Mavericks and my crew and myself.
Yeah,
you know,
yeah.
Like, I want to be the best that I can be. So if you say, oh, he's just a dope dancer, you know?
Yeah.
That's what I want to do, and that's what I come in the game to do, you know? Because it doesn't have to be such a, you know, a thing when we walk around it to get to the top, to be the top spot.
Because yeah.
People, not everyone can be a striker.
Because then the goal's left wide open.
That's right.
Deep shit, though, guys. You know, I think Renegade is basically one of your main coaches.
That's right, yeah. He's my only main teacher.
Right.
That's right. It's a lot of influence from him, you know?
Yeah. What's Renegade like as a teacher?
Renegade, yeah, he's a really good teacher. Though, like, very, very hard, honest. Very honest.
Very honest.
Yeah, very honest.
He made me cry.
Yeah. He will tell you how it is. I think that reality check for me was a big thing in my breaking career. From early. Because, you know, he just told me straight away, oh, that's crap. Okay.
And you're also a personal trainer. So, I mean, do you have any tips for anyone who's hit like a plateau or needs to train differently? A lot of guys and girls watch the people who are like, they want to really understand what it takes to be really good.
Yeah, for a plateau, it's just a different approach. I think maybe something that you're doing, people get so used to raging and they get used to doing the same thing again and again and again. And that's the same for the guys in the workshop. Just, you know, there's so many things you can train, and that one little thing will set up a spark to take you to a next level in your training. And it's maybe that one little thing that you don't really want to focus on. Is the thing that will take you there, you know?
Right, but the one thing you're thinking, I don't want to do that, so that's the thing you've got to do.
That's right, yeah. Like, you know, some things that people just focus on, one combo, and they do that combo for ages. Some people have been doing theirs for like how many years, and they don't understand why they can be in the class. So, like, you have to learn how to manage that under pressure. That's why we think the guys do that under pressure.
Yeah.
You know,
it's
not just doing the moves, it's doing them under pressure, which is the hard part.
It's just seeing that, like, so I think in the workshop when I was watching it, someone was like, right, 5 step, all right, now 7 step, now 5 step. Like, I'm in your face, your mom. It's like, damn.
I was like, we should just throw cusses out, be in their face, like.
Exactly.
It's more like a simulation, a B-boy real life simulation.
Yeah, yeah.
It's a different kind of workshop.
Yeah, because you were saying, like, you know how to say your mom in like 5 languages now.
Someone will be cussing you in the cypher, that's the realness of it, you know. Someone's gonna tell you about yourself in the cypher.
Yeah.
If it's whack, they'll tell you.
That's true. So when I next to be training, better watch out.
Cussing.
A cussing assistant just to stand there. Maybe like kick me once in a while, spit in my face.
You're battling. Are you finding that like you know, get to that kind of level, there's something that's stopping you doing it?
Energy level and injuries. I'll drill something for a while and I'll get better at it, and then I can't practice anymore because I've messed something up. I've hurt my hand, or I've pulled a muscle, or I've injured my elbow. So
yeah.
I think that thing that you said about going back to something that maybe you won't want to train,
yes,
it's kind of hit a point, because it's that thing is the kind of the injury prevention stuff, the exercise and the conditioning.
People say it like this, you say train like an athlete. You want to become like world class, you want to train like every single day, you know, like you say, wake up in the morning, roll out, do push-ups, like that kind of thing. So like,
you have to ease into that process, yeah, you know, and you become the athlete, you know, you don't just jump into it, I'm gonna be athlete, yeah. No, you just add little bits, that's what I'm saying to the guys in the workshop, just add little bits to what you're doing, and then you become what you want to do. Athletes aren't normal people.
They're superhuman.
Yeah. You go to bed early, you get up, you eat differently, you've got to do those important things, but it's all for benefit, you know, it's all for something greater than what you think it is.
I'm taking a lot of Sam's time right now, you know, he's got some training to do, he's got some athletic training to be doing right now. He's got his man up here, he's also his cameraman. You want to say hi? Jump in.
We're waving.
It's
so amazing.
So it's on Troy right now, that's it. Is there anything else you want to say before we wrap up?
Thank you for having me, guys. Like,
thank you. Do you want to plug anything?
Yeah, about my SoundCloud. Yeah.
Right, SoundCloud.
Yeah, because I'm also doing the music thing as well, guys. Yeah. So
you're dropping the website as well.
Yeah, okay. Drop it down.
Free promotion.
Yeah, that's right, free promotion. www.soundcloud.com/smldn. That's SMLDN. Don't just click on it and check the tracks. Follow me, like something, you know, sort them.
Signing off with a boom boom kaka, a boom boom kaka. Pow!
Peace.